In the meantime, grease your tins. We're looking for 4 8-inch tins. We all know what 8 inches looks like, don't we? Don't we? Hi, I'm Michael Chakraverty. Welcome back to my kitchen for a wee bit of baking. And this month it's Pride with my freshly ironed little plastic out of date flags. We love that. And we are baking to celebrate the release of the Sailor Moon. Oh, God almighty. And we are also celebrating the release of the Sailor Moon movies onto Netflix. So we are making a unicorn cake because what is gayer than a unicorn? And in Sailor Moon, there is also a Pegasus, which is basically just like a fancy unicorn, right? So it all ties together, it's golden, we're gonna be grand. It's actually quite a basic recipe, but I've never actually made it in full. So we're gonna go on a journey together. Super simply, you can do this by hand. If you're doing it by hand, pick your strong arm. We've all got one. But I'm gonna just use a stand mixer because I can't be bothered. And I've got tired arms and I'm not gonna answer why. So, into your mixer, put 500 grams of unsalted butter and 500 grams of sugar and just whack it all in. Sorted. Oh. And then we're gonna put in a tablespoon worth of vanilla extract as well. And we're just gonna beat it until it goes properly creamy. Ooh, that sounded a bit rude. Beat it till it goes creamy, yes, you heard me right. So we're gonna beat it really, really hard until it goes properly white. Like think founding fathers white. That's how white we're going. So while that goes, measure out 500 grams of self-raising flour and then add an extra 2 teaspoons of baking powder. And now we wait for this to be properly creamy. You could, in the meantime, grease your tins. We're looking for 4 8-inch tins. We all know what 8 inches looks like, don't we? Don't we? Size doesn't matter, but in this one it does matter. So, I've been meaning to watch Sailor Moon for a really long time, and why didn't no one tell me how iconic it was? And also, how hot Mamoru is? I don't think I've ever fancied a drawing before, but the things I would let that cartoon do to me. Anyway, while we think about that, we're gonna start beating some eggs. We're gonna get 8 large eggs, or if you've got medium eggs, try 10 of those. And just, oh, don't crack them onto the surface like that. We're just gonna clean that one up and we're gonna start again. How do you clean up an egg? Well, I can't get the yolk. Why does this always happen when I'm being filmed? Oh, this is awful. Take 2, okay. You need 8 large eggs or 10 medium ones if you've got them. Try not to crack them on the table. And we're gonna pop all 8 large eggs into a bowl and beat them. Beat them like I want Mamoru to beat them. No. So we've got our flour mixture, we've got our egg mixture, and we're gonna get this just even more creamy. Think House of the Parliament if you're in Britain, think Founding Fathers if you're in America. White as you can possibly imagine. I'm gonna turn it up, let's see what happens. Oh my, it's quite aggressive. You might need to just scrape down the sides a wee bit to make sure you're getting everything. That'll do, I can't bother waiting anymore. So, scrape down the edges. It should be properly creamy and pale and white, and you shouldn't be able to see any kind of bits of sugar in it. Scrape it all up, make sure you've got it all into the center, and then we're gonna start adding the eggs. Pop in a wee bit of the eggs, not too much. Not as much as that, for example. And then pop your beater on really high to combine that all together. Oh, that is one sound that you hear only in baking and during other activities. Very sloppy. Make sure it's fully combined. And then add just a wee bit more. It might split, it might look a bit gross. I think that's fine. It always looks gross when I do it, so. Just before we add the final bit, I am going to scrape down the sides. So it might curdle like mine has, look a bit like scrambled egg. We're just gonna power through. It's gonna be fine. Just don't look at it too closely. Oh. Add the final bit and beat all of that in. So it might look too liquidy at the moment. Don't worry, we're gonna pop in the flour shortly. That's gonna sort that right out. So give it a wee scrape and a scoop. Oh, it looks genuinely like sick. Oh well, What's pride without a bit of vomit, hey? Oh, it's... Tastes fine. If you're in America, don't eat the eggs. Don't eat the eggs. Raw, obviously. Pop in a wee bit of the flour. And then on the lowest setting, slowly mix that in. If you're doing it by hand, you want to make like Moira Rose and fold with a scoop, pat, pat, scoop, pat, pat. Once that's nearly all combined, just add the rest of the flour in. Try and get most of it in the bowl like I'm not doing. And just let it all come together. And then we have the batter. Look at that. This is a basic Victoria sponge. We love to see it. And that's us. Scrape off this. And then we are going to get colouring to make it as gay as we possibly can. Make sure the sides are all scraped down and in. Try not to overbeat it, otherwise it's going to get a wee bit tough. It should look like that. And then we're going to get four more bowls out. Like that. Pop out your four bowls. And you could measure this. But who has the time? Gays don't do maths, we're just going to do it by eye. So get a big spoon and measure it by dollop, the technical term. So I'm just going to measure it out equally into each bowl. I say equally, that looks about the same size as the other one. Be fine, be fine. If you end up with uneven layers, just call it an inclusive, a body positive rainbow. There is a lot of batter here, but we are making a lot of cake. This is not one to eat on your own, unless you live on your own. Actually, I'm not one to tell you what to do. Eat it on your own if you want, why not? Eat it while watching Sailor Moon. And thirsting after Mamoru. Also, just quickly, I feel like if a circus called the Dead Moon Circus came to my hometown, I probably wouldn't go. Do you know what I mean? Why are they surprised that bad shit's happening when they go to a circus that's called Dead Moon? They deserve it, if I'm honest. Oh, I love it raw. Batter, I like batter raw. So I'm gonna go for red, yellow, green and blue. If you don't fancy doing any coloring, just put them in like that. Or if you wanna make them chocolatey, just sub out some of the flour, put it into cocoa powder. Do what you want, it's your life. Lead it how you want. I'm gonna start with the red. I always use a gel-based food coloring because it bakes out better and it's a bit stronger. It's important to remember with these that any colour that you put into your body when you eat cake will come out of your body. So tomorrow, when your shit is like a mixture of green and blue, don't panic. You're not rotting from the inside. You've just had a rainbow cake. Speaking from experience on that one. God, gays are always talking about shit, didn't we? Right. Stir that in. You want to fold it again, like Moira Rose. Scoop, pat, pat. Because if you beat it, the flour is going to make it go all tough, and that'll be gross, and you'll be sad. And it'll be your fault. So we've got all four of our colours. We need to get our tins. I've already greased and lined mine. We're looking for 8 inches or 20 centimeters. Size does matter here in this instance specifically. Super simply, just pop your batter in there. Oh, seagulls are back, they're excited about this bit. Spread it out right to the edges and try and level it off as much as you possibly can. If you get wonky sponges, it's not the end of the world. Again, body positivity, we're all for it. It's a really unappetizing color when you think that's gonna be inside you. Ever look at things and think, God, that's gonna be gross inside. No, I'm gonna cut that one off before you even get it in the edit. How am I ever gonna get a boyfriend, honestly? Like that. While you're doing this, actually, your oven should be preheating. We're aiming at 200 degrees Fahrenheit, 180 degrees fan, or if you're in the past, it is gas mark 6. And if you're still using a gas mark oven, please, please, I beg you, just do better, okay? Now these are all pretty much sorted. We're gonna pop them all in our preheated oven. Try and get them all in at the same time. If you're gonna have to put them in two at a time, make half the batter at a time, if that makes sense. Because if the self-raising flour is already in here and it's sat on the side, it's gonna start working but have nowhere to go. By the time it goes in the oven, you'll make a pancake. It'll be a delicious multicolored pancake, but it won't be what you want. So if you're going to have to bake in batches, make the batter in batches as well. Science. Right, I'm going to put all these in the oven. We're going to go in for 20 minutes. So I've done a wee bit of cleaning, but it's time to get the cakes out of the oven. It's been 20 minutes. Bear with. So if I stick a skewer down into the center, it comes out completely clean. So what we'll do is we'll leave these in their tins for 5 minutes, and then we will take them out and leave them to cool completely on the wire racks. We've got plenty other jobs to do while these cool, so I'm gonna go and put them somewhere else. Is the floor okay for a cake? I'm just gonna put them on the floor, that's gonna be fine. I feel like that's fine. Nothing more pride than ending up on the floor, hey! We love that. Now, we need to make the rest of the unicorn's features. We're gonna do two ears and one horn, because the horn is the gayest part of a unicorn. But to start with, we're gonna go with the ears. So get a white piece of fondant, and get a wee bit of icing sugar, and dust your surface. Oh, that's very lumpy. That's what he said. Well, I hope he didn't say that, actually. That'd be quite a shame for him, wouldn't it? And roll that out. I'm gonna roll mine fairly thin, to maybe like a centimetre max. And then get a knife. So with your knife, you're gonna cut out a teardrop shape. Again, you can use a template. I'm just gonna eyeball it. Lovely. And to make sure they're even, I'm gonna use that as a template to make another one. And then just make sure the bottoms are straight, the only straight thing about this cake, and pop them to a side. And then get some pink food coloring or white color pink and roll that out as well. And that's gonna make the inside of the ears. If you see these cakes on Instagram, some folk use gold. I don't have any gold fondant, so I'm not using that, but you can do whatever color you want, really. It's up to you. Oh, that's a ship's horn, as you were. Got even the ship's horny at this point. Christ alive. Lockdown has been hard for all of us, especially those in the boating industry. I don't know what I'm talking about. Oh look, words are still coming out of my mouth. I'm gonna make this just a wee bit thinner than the white. And just get a quick gauge of eye in terms of how big your ear is, because you want it to be smaller to go in the center of the ear. And just draw another little teardrop shape. Like that. You should probably cut onto a chopping board, shouldn't you? I mean, that's literally what they were made for. Hey ho, don't tell me how to live. Right. Chop off the bottom, make them straight again. And what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna get a wee bit of water, dab that on the center of each white ear and stick the pink on top. Just get that a wee bit wet. It's been a long time since, not gonna say that one either. Sorry, I'm using the tap, which is probably not the most photogenic thing, but it's too late now. And you stick the center of the ear on and just give it a quick pat to kind of secure it in place. Lovely jubbly. So you just pinch them in together and leave a little bit at the bottom there, and do the same with the other one. So picking it up, squeezing them together and pinching them there. If they look slightly different, that's fine. No two ears. We're gonna think of them as sisters rather than twins. And then into the bottom, get a wee cocktail stick and stick a cocktail stick in. And we'll leave that to dry. Now, ideally you'd leave that overnight. I've got some I made earlier. You can leave them for ages and ages and ages. You want them to go as hard as you possibly can. The harder, the better. Heard that before. And now, for the most important part, the horn. Now, horns come in all shapes and sizes, and all lengths, all colors. That's all up to you. Do what you feel is right. But to start off with, you need to get two balls. A fairly good weight of ball. I'm gonna say 100 gram balls there. And you're gonna roll them into, there's no way not to make this phallic. So mum, if you can just like skip ahead like 20 seconds, that'll be great for me. Thank you so much. Roll one of your balls into a sausage. Again, length is up to you, girth is up to you, but you do want it to taper. you always want it to taper, don't you, really? Actually, no. Some people wouldn't, and I shouldn't misrepresent the community like that. So I'm sorry to all of those who are, you know. Actually, that's tapered as well, isn't it? I used to think people did that, which is quite aggressive. So you want to get your horn to be slightly thicker at one end and slightly thinner at the other, like a parsnip, if you will. And we're going to roll that out there. And then using that one as a guide, we're going to make the same again. Get a wee bit of water, wet the long edge of one of your horns, and stick that to the other one. And then, quite simply, you're just going to twist it together. Be gentle. No one likes a rough hand on their horn. Oh dear, this is my job. So now we've got the horn together. Pinch the ends together a wee bit. I tend to twist it and then pull it off. If it's not sticking together, just use a wee bit more water. And there you have your horn. Just cut off the base there. And you've got your horn there, look. Sorted, lovely. Gonna actually move that from where it's positioned there. Now you want to get a big skewer and shove it in its bum. So go right through the center there, leaving a long stick out the bottom there. And we're gonna leave that to cool and to dry out, and it wants to go very hard. You want your horn to be as hard as possible. We're just gonna lean into it now. You want a rock hard horn. You can make your horn whatever color you want it to be. Of course, horns come in all shapes, sizes, and colors. I've sprayed mine gold, which you'll see later, but we're gonna set these to the side and let them cool for now. Next up is the buttercream. Now, it's gonna sound like a lot, but bear with me. We're gonna put 500 grams of butter in here. And then this, if you're wondering what it looks like, is a kilogram of icing sugar. It's quite a lot. And we're gonna do a lot more beating. So in your stand mixer, you've got your 500 grams of butter. You're gonna start beating that now. You can use your arm. Again, pick your strong one, but it's gonna take you a long time. Even the most seasoned right armor is never gonna get through it. So beat it till it's a wee bit soft. And once it's gone a wee bit soft, you're going to start adding the icing sugar a little bit at a time. I know you're gonna want to throw more in as you go, but more gradually is better because it's gonna be a right mess. Once you've added your icing sugar, put it on a very low speed. Let that combine before you whip it up again to a high speed and just keep repeating that process. It takes a really long time, I'm not gonna lie to you. I feel like Sailor Moon is quite a gay movie, really. I mean, the gays are going to be all for the girls' superhero costumes, and obviously Mamoru. And also, we love a camp villain, do you know what I mean? Even if they are members of a stupidly titled circus. Do you know what? I'm going to do what I've been telling you not to do. I'm just going to pour it all in. Let's just see what happens. We live for chaos. Oh no, I don't want to put it on. Just going to put that like that. Oh no. Oh no, this is not good. Yeah, don't do this. It's struggling. It's gonna be fine. It's gonna be fine, everybody. I planned this. Actually, that's not too bad. So, you might notice that your buttercream goes a bit yellow. It looks a little bit, just a little bit like piss. So what we're going to do, here's a bit of science for you. Are you ready? Here's a new show. Hi, it's Michael. Welcome to my kitchen for a wee bit of science. On a colour wheel, you have purple at one side and opposite it is yellow. So to counteract all the yellow in the buttercream, we're going to add like a tiny, tiny bit of purple. Science. Look at that. Get a toothpick, and I mean like the tiniest bit of purple. And you're just going to smidge it on like that. You can always add more, but you can't take it away. Pop that in and give it a good beat. There we go. So you can see already on that there, that rather than being yellowy, it's gone nice and white, which is what we want. This is quite stiff at the moment and we don't want it stiff. Again, stiff is often good, but not in this situation. So we're gonna add a wee bit of milk just to loosen it up a bit. It's like the first drink on the night out, you know. Give that a beat, let it come together. And there we are, a massive song and dance, but we finally got some buttercream, which means we are golden and we are good to go with the assembly. So we've got everything that we need. We've got all of our cakes, which have cooled. We've got a turntable, which is fancy. You can just put it on a plate if you like. I've got a board, which is 10 inches, which will fit an 8-inch cake. And we've got all of our massive vat of buttercream. If it starts going a bit stiff, just beat it into submission as hard as you can. And it'll be fine. So we're going to start off by leveling the cakes. So you want to level off the blue one first, because that's going first. I do it by eye. You can measure it. Totally up to you. And be very careful with the knives. If you've seen me on Bake Off, you'll know why. I've got the scars both inside and out. On to that. We're going to put the green cake. So basically we're going to level, put on, cover in jam, cover in buttercream, and repeat, and repeat, and repeat. Hopefully we can do a thing where we speed this bit up, because it's going to be quite long for me. But hopefully only a couple of seconds for you. I'm going to use a bread scraper and just start to smooth the edges around to try and make them even where possible. So I'm happy enough, I think, that I'm going to start smoothing off the top. I don't think it needs to be perfect. Who is? And also it's Pride, we should be out dancing, so who has the time to spend all of their time making it absolutely bang on perfect? We'll cover up the ugly bits with bits of hair. What I'm just doing now is I'm catching the edges and pulling them in towards the center, so there's no kind of ridges around the edge. If you're struggling a bit, if you wet the blade, it smooths things off just a wee bit more. Like when, I don't know if you like this, when you get like spreadable butter in a carton. I like it to be properly smooth on top, so I like to smooth that out. She doesn't like it hairy or rough. Actually, no, that's a lie. I just made that to make an innuendo. I'm gonna find the front and check it all looks decent. That's the front for me there. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get a wee cocktail stick and I'm gonna mark two eyes so I know where the eyes are gonna go. I can't find the cocktail stick, so I'm gonna have to think of something else. Do you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna use the cocktail stick that's in the bottom of my ears. Look at that. Okay, so front of the cake is going to be here. So get your horn. I painted mine nice and gold. Wherever the front of the cake is going to be, which for me is there, stick the skewer in roughly the center. And you might feel a wee bit of resistance as you push in. So just be smooth, don't just crack it. No one wants a cracked or broken or bent horn, do they? Although I suppose sometimes an upward curve is great. There we go. That's our horn in. And then we're gonna stick our ears kind of equal distance apart into the top next to it. Let's check where the front is. And there. Don't worry too much about them being visible at the bottom. We're gonna cover it up with buttercream anyway. And there we have it. That's the bottom lines of what we're doing here. And then using your piping bags full of colored buttercreams, we're just gonna pipe swirls to make hair all around. So do what you want, whether you wanna make like little like sticky uppy bits like that. And there we have it. A excuse my covered in food colouring mouth, but now we have a full trans pride mane. You can do whatever colours you want, or just one colour. And all we need to do now is pipe on the eyes. So what I've got in this piping bag is a mixture of egg whites, icing sugar and black food colouring whipped up to make a firm royal icing. I'm just going to pipe on the eyes. This is where it could all go wrong. So feel free to leave your unicorn eyeless or just take a quick look at mine now before I ruin it. So using those dots that I put down earlier, I'm going to try and pipe on some eyes. So she's got slightly wonky eyelashes, bit to your gun of her, but this is my final unicorn. There we are, celebrating the Pegasus stroke unicorn Helios in Sailor Moon, as well as Pride. We've got white, pink and blue for trans flag. Inside we've got rainbows, bit of black there, and I'm brown, progress. Look at us, here we go. Right, there you are, perfect little rainbow unicorn on a dishcloth for your viewing pleasure. Smashed it, mate. First time that. That's not bad. I'm quite proud of that. God, I'm good. I should go on Bake Off. I feel a bit bad cutting into it, but as is the gay way, I'm gonna go in from behind to save the face. So let's cut in right down the back. Can you imagine if it was all burnt at this point? Need to get a plate, don't I? Now that's a fairly gay cake, isn't it? That's not bad. I'm gonna see if I can hold it up. Look at that. God, I'm such a professional. I'm actually a legend. Look at this. Look at that. I made that. That's not bad, is it? I'm gonna eat it. It might taste like shit, actually. I'm gonna try and cut into it. I'm gonna leave that on the front. Oh, shit. How do you eat this thing? Right, let's go. Yeah. Definitely edible. That's what we were aiming for. That's good. All of this is gonna be in me through Pride Month. It might take a bit of time, but I'm gonna commit to it. I'm gonna eat the whole thing. I'll let you know how I get on. If I pass away, you know why. And there we have it. A unicorn cake! So fucking extra. The horniest cake for Pride Month and for Sailor Moon. Enjoy it on Netflix now.